Hello there everybody, it is me, FreezerBunny, and welcome back to another Sims 4 speed build. So today we are building the Uptown Terrace. Now this is a very luxurious apartment here in the university world of Brightchester. This apartment ended up having a total of 4 bedrooms and 4.5 bathrooms. So each bedroom has its own ensuite bath. One of the bedrooms is furnished as a butler's room, and another one of the bedrooms is furnished as an office, but you're free to convert it and do whatever you want with it, to be honest. I did make this as a residential lot. To be honest, I didn't really see students living in here, but you're free to move students in here if that's what you want. In this build, I am also using CC, which is something I'm super excited about because that's not something that I do often, to be honest. I think I've only done one other CC build this year, so I was very excited to try out some new CC from some amazing creators that I know. Most of the CC that I used in this build is from the amazing Felixandre on Patreon, but I also used some items from the Jim07 from All the Sims and ZXTA on Tumblr. Of course, all of the CC I used will be linked down in the description below. Please keep in mind that for Felixandre CC, you will need to be a patron of him on Patreon, but let me tell you guys that as a supporter of Felix, his CC is so worth it because it's so inspiring. To be honest, like, whenever I see a new set from him, I just get so many ideas for new builds. So let me tell you, that $20 that I paid for his back catalog is more than worth it. But yeah, this build is just so much fun to do because building it at first was definitely a process. I think I must have built this exterior 3 or 4 times. The first time I built it, I had no idea about the rules for building university penthouses, and I tried doing like some designs that I really wasn't happy about, so I ended up scrapping my first attempt and I tweeted about it, and somebody suggested I use the tool mod because I really wanted to put some decorations on these exterior walls, but you can't do that because it's on the edge of the lot, so it's not letting me put decorations. So I used the tool mod and I finally got to do what I wanted. Unfortunately, at some point I discovered that you actually can't package lots with items you moved outside of the lot using the tool mod, so that second attempt I also had to scratch because it was kind of pointless having all of those items on the outside of the lot boundary because you can't share it anyways. So I ended up just scrapping that second attempt, and then this is the eventual outcome of the third attempt, which to be honest I'm really really happy with. It did end up a little bit simpler than what I initially imagined at first, but I kind of like it. You know, it's very very classical, very kind of simple, understated. It has a little bit of an art deco detail to it as well, especially with like that roof trim detail and that lowest half wall detail like on the roof area. I really really like it. It kind of reminds me a lot of like Art Deco. Also a little bit of a French vibe as well because of this roof and that dormer detail. But overall for the style, I did go for a more classical style because if you look at the base of this building, you'll see that a lot of details are actually more of a classical style because the windows on the base of this building has what we call a Gibbs surround, which is more of a detail from classical style architecture like neoclassical and Baroque and Renaissance architecture. So that's kind of the overall vibe that I went with. To be honest, I was really, really confused at first because I just didn't get this base. It just looked, to be honest, to me, it kind of looked like a step pyramid or like a ziggurat. I get that they were probably trying to go for that whole cloister look that we would see in like medieval universities, but it just looked really weird. Like the shape of this base just looks like a step pyramid. But overall, I'm just trying to replicate the architectural details that it has on the base. So like I said, the classical details and also the archways, which is what I ended up doing here in this build. I did end up with a shape that's very, very similar to the original student dorm that was on this lot, but I don't hate it. It's different in its own way, and I'm really, really happy with the shape that I came up with. So I am using these amazing archways to make this kind of like colonnade. It's just amazing. It's just one of the reasons why I love this build. And I also use a lot of that on the interior as well. I love this archway area that separates this kind of like entrance lobby from the rest of the living area of this apartment. And now here I'm actually showing you guys a whole process of me having to do this floor plan, and I think it took me about an hour to figure out the floor plan for this build. And the reason for that is because it had such a limited space. This was only a single story build, and I wanted to fit in so many rooms in here. I knew that I wanted to have a butler's room and at least three other bedrooms, so that was kind of a challenge. So I literally took me an hour to figure out the floor plan in the end, but I wanted to show it to you guys just so you guys can see the whole process, because it is a process in architecture. Doing the floor plan does take a lot of time, and it also involves a lot of adjustments and all of that good stuff. So you can see me trying to just try out different options in here. And yeah, in the end, I'm really, really happy with what I came up with. I'm also doing this on the tallest wall height, which isn't something that I also do quite often, but I find that with using Felixandre CC, I kind of have to use it with either the tallest or the second tallest wall height. It wasn't part of the plan at first, but I did use those open doors quite a lot in this build. You guys know from my Parisian apartment series that I've done about a month ago, my fondness for these open doors, and I'm so happy that there's actually CC for that, so that I don't have to, you know, take up so much of my time trying to make that open door technique that I love. And here I am doing this custom floor pattern using a floor from Vampires. So this is a completely CC-free floor, if I can say that. It's the Vampires floor. I just rotated it four times using the period key on my keyboard, and I was able to come up with this kind of, what is this called, parquet pattern, I guess. So yeah, I was really, really happy with that. And yeah, for the interior, once again, I just went for a very, very understated classical style. While I was tweeting previews for this build, I was throwing some references from the Sex and the City movie, because, you know, like during the beginning of that movie, Mr. Big and Carrie were looking for a penthouse apartment, and that was kind of the vibe I was going for, to be honest, not gonna lie. Because that apartment is just so gorgeous, and I actually stalked that apartment in real life. It's actually not a penthouse, it's a full-on townhouse, like the real life location, but in the movie they kind of made it look like it was a penthouse, and it was so gorgeous. So that was kind of like the inspiration for this main great room area, with like the arched windows and the beautiful, beautiful light that goes into it and opens up into the balcony as well. Really, really love that detail. And I gotta say, one of my favorite things in this room is that 5-tile long table, which came from one of Felixandre's recent sets. It is just so beautiful, and I'm so, so happy I finally got to use it in this build. I'm also really happy that this room ended up being quite open. Like, we have all of those open doors that open up to the balcony, which I also really, really enjoy as well. But overall, I did go for a very understated look for this interior. Just some flourishes of antique items and paintings in here and there, but overall I just went for something that's very minimalist almost, which is pretty compatible with a classical style, because for those of you who are familiar with architectural history, the neoclassical style is kind of the more minimalist of all of the, you know, classical styles, especially if you put it alongside styles like Baroque and Rococo, which is just so detailed and elaborate. Neoclassical style does tend to be a little bit more minimal, does have more geometric detailing, and it's just so elegant in my opinion. So yeah, I also love that detail of the modern sofas in the main living room. I just really, really love that juxtaposition between, you know, antique furniture and more modern minimalist furniture. It just looks so good. I believe that style is called eclectic style. But now we are moving on to the kitchen, and here I'm mainly using the kitchen set by the amazing Hey Harrie and Felixandre. I believe this set is actually available for free. So I will put a separate link to that. Some of Felixandre's CC is actually available for free. I know that one of his earlier sets was made available for free as well. So if you want to try out his CC, see how it works in your game, and see how you like it in game, you can go ahead and download that for free, and also this set as well, because it is so beautiful. Definitely one of the best kitchens I've ever seen. It kind of blows my mind how people can make this and offer it for free for people to just download, and it's honestly superior quality to what EA has put out, in my own personal opinion. My favorite part of this kitchen set is actually the plants, which I used so much all throughout this build. So you guys will see a little bit more of that as we go on to this build. I love this corner plant actually that I used here. It has this little hanging bit from that vine, and it just looks really, really good. So I really enjoyed using that. You will be seeing a lot of that in this build as well. But yeah, for this kitchen, I just ended up using a lot of warmer colors to be more consistent with the rest of this penthouse, and I just wanted it to be a little bit more homey. To be honest, I think I would have preferred this to be more open. Like, I would have loved to have incorporated like some sort of balcony on the kitchen, but to be honest, there was really no room for that. But overall, I'm really, really happy with that kitchen. Moving on to this master bedroom. Now, this is the largest bedroom in the house, and I gotta say, I just really, really enjoyed furnishing it because it is completely my style. I love the vibe of this room. I love the very laid-back vibe I ended up having in this room. And yeah, it just completely my style. I'm really, really happy with how it turned out in the end. Very, very spacious, and I'm using that Black Panther statue from the Gym 07. I believe that's the only piece of CC I'm using from him, and this is actually a free piece from Mother Sims, and let me just say, it is so gorgeous. It's definitely one of my favorite sculptures from any CC that I've seen before. Because it can work for like modern styles, it can work for like a traditional style. I just really, really love that piece. And for this room, I did put like a feature wall. I put like a black wood paneling as a feature wall, but actually most of this penthouse just has white walls, because you guys know me, I love my plain white wall. There's just something about it that I find so elegant and so just so beautiful. So here we have like a little sitting area slash lounging area, I guess, with like a TV. The TV is placed on an Egyptian coffee table, which I did enjoy because I like the idea of mixing these modern and antique furniture. Maybe some of this furniture is from centuries ago or maybe millennia ago, if you guys get what I mean. So here we also have a little office area. So yeah, I love this, once again, a mix of modern and traditional. And I also used that bookshelf from Fitness Stuff, and I'm really, really happy with how it looks in this room. I think it fits in so well with all of the other furniture, and I'm just throwing in some paintings in here just to add a little bit of a splash of color into this room as well. But moving on to the walk-in closet. Now, this whole room was meant to be the master bathroom, but I couldn't imagine a penthouse like this not having a walk-in closet, so I split it in half and I made the one half of it into the bathroom and the other half of it into the walk-in closet. And it's kind of a bummer that I didn't get to keep the other door that opens up into this balcony, but the Sims actually can't get onto the balcony anyway, so that's more of like a decoration. And for those of you who are calling me out for the privacy aspects of that balcony, of course you can always just close the door if your Sims would like some privacy while they're taking a bath. But to be honest, I wish this bathroom was a little bit bigger. I think it's a little bit small for my liking, but overall I'm still really happy with how elegant and glamorous it turned out. And yeah, it is what it is. It's fully functional though still, so you know, the size I think really isn't a big deal considering this is a penthouse. So yeah, moving on to the office area, which also can be turned into a bedroom. This room also has its own ensuite bath, by the way, so you can easily just make this into a bedroom if you want to. Just delete the desk and just throw in a bed and it's a bedroom. By the way, I did have some specific Sims in mind as I was doing this. Definitely they are somebody who has a very prestigious position in this university. I imagine the husband to be kind of like some sort of board member or like board of directors, something like that. So this would definitely be their office, and they would definitely have some important meetings in here. I could also see the main living room having that function as well, of kind of like a meeting slash entertainment area. And then the wife, I imagine her to be somebody who's more involved in charity work and supporting different like student organizations. But yeah, they definitely are more of like a high society couple, definitely very, very glamorous. I like that detail of having the Brightchester logo on the entrance of this room. I'm not sure if you guys caught it, but I really, really like that detail. But for this room, I just went really, really corporate. So yeah, I love that detail of having that metal case as well from Strangerville, and you can actually put medals in there for your achievements, and I will be putting those in eventually off camera, because you have to click and drag them using a sim. So yeah, I'm really, really happy with this room actually. I'm just very, very happy with how it turned out in the end. Now, as I mentioned earlier, you are free to download this on the gallery. Just please keep in mind that you should make sure that your custom content filter is enabled, because if it's not, then this build isn't gonna show up even if you search for it. But all of the hashtags for that should be in the description. Unfortunately, I can't link CC builds directly onto this video because you can't really search for it on the gallery website. I just feel like pointing that out because a lot of people seem to have trouble finding CC builds on the gallery. But you guys just saw me furnish the butler's room, and it's a tiny room, but to be honest, what else do you expect for a butler's room, right? But I just wanted to show it to you guys because it's not something that we see quite often in builds. Unfortunately, because of that, I had to take out all of the footage of me furnishing the guest bedroom, but you will be seeing it in the screenshots of the floor plans anyway, so I really didn't feel like showing it because there really wasn't a need for that. It's kind of just a basic bedroom anyway, but this vestibule right here is probably one of my favorite rooms in this entire house. I love how you can see glimpses of kind of like the main living room area, and it just looks so glamorous, and I think it makes for a pretty epic entrance to this penthouse. So here I am making some changes to this main living area, and that's mainly because I really wanted to incorporate a fireplace in here, so I put one in the middle, and then I put one of those like Renaissance classical paintings in there as well. I do put quite a couple of Felixandre's new paintings in this build as well, which I really like his kind of like Tudor like Renaissance paintings. They look so good, so I will be putting those off camera. But moving on to this balcony area, which another one of my favorite aspects of this build, is just this gorgeous balcony. It's just so beautiful. So here I'm using these ivy from the amazing creator ZXTA on Tumblr. I have used some of her CC before, especially some of her Sims Medieval conversions on a medieval castle that I built about a year ago. I did a full-on series on that, and I've also used these vines on that build as well, but here I just wanted it to make it more of like hanging garden kind of concept. So I just really love that idea. We did go for this classical style anyway, so I thought that having this kind of like really amazing like epic hanging garden was just so appropriate for this overall vibe. I didn't like overload this area with plants, but I might have overloaded it with this ivy, but I think it still works. I didn't put ivy on the outer facing parts of this build because I thought it looked weird for the gallery thumbnail, but I thought that this area just felt really cozy, also really glamorous as well, and I really enjoy doing it. So on this one side we have kind of like some lounge chairs. I believe these are from Felixandre's tropical set? Colonial set? So yeah, this is just a nice lounging area. And then on the other side we have kind of like an outdoor dining area slash bar. To be honest, I would have loved to have had a pool in here. If I can put a pool on penthouse, I would have put one probably like where the planter boxes is, like as an infinity pool or something like that, but unfortunately we can't, so I had to settle in for a water feature, which I initially chose as a fountain bird bath kind of thing, but I ended up not liking it because of just how big it was, so I ended up replacing it with another kind of like wall mounted fountain from Romantic Garden. So here I am just incorporating this outdoor dining area and a bar. I put one of those like globe bars from, I believe it was Luxury Party, it's either that or Vintage Glamour. I put one of that inside, and then I put another bar here on the outside as well, and you guys just saw me incorporate that wall-mounted fountain as well as that fire pit, which is actually a functional fire pit, much to my surprise, but I think that's actually going to be it for this build. So hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, please feel free to share this video and leave a comment letting me know how you feel about it. Other than that, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up my commentary right here. As always, thank you so much for watching. You all have an awesome day. Enjoy the rest of the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.